Welcome to Around the Clock. I'm your host, Yolanda Greaves. Today we are celebrating the summer solstice, which is the longest day or the most light in the year. And we are getting ready for a great show. We have Alex Carlton of the Ashland Business Association. She'll be speaking with us about all the great things and new things and initiatives that the Business Association is working on. We'll also have our Around the Town tour and, of course, our Selectmen's Update. So, stay with us and we'll be back with more of Around the Clock.
Hey, 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 we're going to the market today.
Come on down to the Ashland Farmers Market, located on the green at 125 Front Street. Free parking is available across from the public library, or you can ride your bikes. The market is open Saturday mornings 9 a.m. to 1 p.m.
Families come from everywhere, local artists sell the wares. Lively music fills the air at Ashland Farmers Market. Saturday mornings will be found in the middle of the town. You can even bring your dog around. At Ashland Farmers Market. Hey, 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 we're going to the market today. Hey, 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 we're going to the market.
Ashland Farmers Market, today. Keeping it local, keeping it fresh.
Welcome back to Around the Clock. It's time for the Selectmen's Update from the meeting held on June 15th, 2016. The meeting started at 7 o'clock. We had some citizens' participation. We moved into a license transfer hearing for the Warren Conference Center. It has changed hands from Northeastern University to Framingham State University, and we had to approve the transfer of the liquor license from one entity to the other, which we did. We also had a presentation by WACA-TV as they were requesting funds from the Cable Enterprise Fund to purchase some new equipment to do some things better at Town Hall as well as at the schools and some other live feeds. And we approved that funding. We also had a joint meeting with the Planning Board and we made an appointment. There was a resignation after the election. So we made an appointment and that position will now be filled through to the next election. So thank you to the gentleman for stepping up and being willing to be on the planning board. We then went into old and new business and we accepted resignations from four members of the Capital Improvement Committee, from Jacob Guggenheim, Alexis Christopher, Ron Mortensen, and Brittany Iacopone. What will happen is it does tie in. We've received a grant through our Community Compact Agreement to do a sort of research and reevaluation of our capital process. So we will be doing that with the members who are left of Capital Improvement and come up with a new process and then most likely advertise for some new volunteers for that committee. We discussed and decided to not vote on. We didn't say no, but we decided to not vote on the self-help agreement request by Campanelli and Thorndike. It relates to money that is coming through the MassWorks grant, and until we hear back from the offices that administer the MassWorks grant, we didn't feel that we could vote on that request for the funding. We also discussed and looked at the road closures that are going to be happening for the Dragonfly Festival. The Dragonfly Festival is presented by Arts Ashland Alliance. It is happening on Saturday, August 13th from 1 to 8 in the evening. And it happens near the Historic Society over on Myrtle Street. So there'll be a small section of Myrtle Street closed and there'll be detours put up. It looks like it should be a great event. This is their third year. They're expanding it. They're adding more businesses and more musicians. So it should be fun. You can go check that out. We also approved a proclamation for CNA Week, which is Caregivers Week. We accepted a gift of $25,000 from Ashland Green LLC. Ashland Green is the organization that is building the senior residential housing up at 466 Chestnut Street through the Green Company. They've been a great partner coming in. They've gifted the house at 22 Elliott Street to the town already. They're now giving us resource to look at possibly rehabbing that house and making it something that we could use and possibly tie it into the Warren Woods. And then we did a declaration of surplus for an ambulance. We'd had an ambulance on order. It is now in. It has been outfitted as an Ashland ambulance, so we don't need the extra ambulance. We then did some selectmen appointments. We have an organization in town called Decisions at Every Turn, and they are in the process of creating a steering committee, and they were looking for a member of the Board of Selectmen to be a part of that. So Joe Mignani, our chair, but also a previous DARE officer, we felt it was appropriate for him to take on that position. So he will be the selectman representative on the Decisions at Every Turn steering committee. We also discussed liaison committee. Liaison is two members of the Board of Selectmen, two members of the school committee, two members of FinCom, town management and assistant town manager and superintendent and assistant superintendent. We try to get together once a month, just make sure that everyone is working from similar information. It gets really critical during budget time, but also just to communicate on what's going on, what are some needs, how are things working where the departments work together. So that is going to be Joe Mignani and myself as the members from the Board of Selectmen. We also reappointed and extended the appointment to our Water Policy Committee. We had some people that were on different timings, so Wayne Bates, Bill Brown, who are residents, and then Regita Puramella, who is our town engineer, their times have been extended to August 31st, 2016, and then they'll get tied in to the other cycle of appointments. We then had an update, town manager reports. We discussed the rail transit district update. We're still having some impact study reviews come in before the blasting permit can be approved. We also were told about the healing ceremony that was happening up on Magunko Hill, and that is tied into the Dan Borelli Nyanza art project that's happening here in town. If you need more information on that, you can go to his website. We also talked about the West Union sewer takings update. We're going to be having hearings on August 3rd. There is some property that needs to be taken, and that ties into the MassWorks grant that we're getting of $6 million to improve some of the sewer over on West Union Street. We are also in the process of hiring a new DPW director. They've done some they've gotten their resumes, and they're looking at doing some interviews. David Manoogian, who we've had many times on the show, left Ashland to go to a position that was a little closer to home. We are also talking about a human services department. So this was tie in the rec department, our youth and family services department, our community center, and other departments that work with people here in town who either need services or are looking for services, bring it into one organization, one department, so that it can work a little more closely together. So if someone comes into food pantry and they need some services, it's a little tied in more quickly. So we're getting some information on that, and that should be rolling in soon, and that is being handled by our assistant town manager, Jennifer Ball. Then the last update we got was on the Route 126 project. Thank you to those who came out to the forum back in middle of June in regards to that project and the update. We have gotten word that as of right now, we are on the tip for 2020, so we are staying where we were. We still will need the community to give public input. And of course, next year around this time, we'll have to make sure that we stay in 2020. And if anything, even do something to, if our project is ready, to possibly bring it into 2019. So we'll stay up to date, and we'll keep you up to date on that. The last thing that we do is board reports. And one of the things that we announced, if you did not go to high school graduation or weren't able to watch it, the selectmen give out two scholarships. And our scholarship recipients this year were Evan Valenti and Ina Kagan. So congratulations to both of them. They're both going off to college. And we wish them the best of luck. So that's the selectmen's update for the June 15th, 2016 meeting. The next selectmen meeting will be happening on the 3rd of August, the first Wednesday in August. Well, that wraps it up for this selectmen update. Stay with us, and we'll be back with more Around the Clock. Welcome back to Around the Clock. We have our guest, Alex Carlton. Alex is the president of the Ashland Business Association. Alex, welcome to Around the Clock.
Thank you very much for having me. I'm excited to be here today.
I asked you on, I think Ashland Business Association is transforming. They're doing a lot of great things. Can you tell us a little bit about what you're working on right now?
Absolutely. Our primary objective right now is launching a new business website. And we're coming at this, if anyone's seen the old one, it was very business focused in the past. And what we're, our primary goal is really helping to grow businesses in Ashland. And what we're creating is a very consumer-friendly website. So instead of talking specifically to businesses, we're talking to the people who are probably looking for the services that our businesses provide. So more like if you're in town and you're just wondering, well, you know, I just moved here, where's a plumber? People be able to go onto our new website and be able to find their businesses that they're looking for there, and in a really nice format that makes it easy to find, really highlights the services that are provided locally. So that's our really big initiative, and that should be launching. It'll be launching definitely by the end of this month. I'm hopeful for this week. We'll see. And then also, we over this past year, we've made a strong initiative to be more collaborative, especially with the town of Ashland, and really increase our communication and how can we partner with the town of Ashland. And we've been working a lot with Beth Reynolds. And so another aspect of this website will be to highlight our businesses that can provide services to other businesses that will be coming into town. So to help recruit other businesses into Ashland to say, we have the services you need here. We can support your businesses. You may not think of Ashland, but we really are the place for business to grow.
Yeah, so Beth Reynolds is our Economic Development Director, has been on since January. I have found she has been a breath of fresh air, and just the energy that she has in regards to this economic development. She's already gotten us deemed a biotech company. She's worked to get some businesses in town. So talk a little bit more about your partnership with her and Town Hall.
Sure. Yeah, so Beth joining in January was fantastic. And I have to say that, you know, she comes from the Metro West Chamber of Commerce. So she's really used to looking at things from a very, like, how does business work with community? How do we promote one another and how do we grow? So I think that was the really nice thing that she brought to the town. And some of the things that she did right off the bat is just helping us get our communication together. For instance, very simple things. We didn't have a really great working communication database of all the businesses in town. So we didn't have a real easy way to reach all of our peers to say, we're doing this. You need to learn about these things or this is going on. So she just really came in and initially just provided a lot of that organization and started coming into the conversations and saying, well, this is how business fits into that community discussion and this is how we can support you. And she constantly amazes me with, I don't know how she knows all the things that are going on and companies that are looking for space, but she's always, always, always have engaged in those conversations in an unbelievably promotional way for the town. She's really been great.
It's been a nice addition. So how many businesses are a part of the Ashland Business Association?
Yes, I should know this off the top of my head. I believe we have 108 businesses. We have 114 total organizations. So there are some community organizations who participate or are lifetime members because of their contributions they've given. And growing. What's really interesting is that over the past even 2 months, I think with a lot of the programming that we've put in place, we've had businesses from outside of Ashland now reaching out to ask us if we can they can join our business association. So.
Well, that says a lot for, for what you're doing. So you're president. How long have you been the president of the association?
So I started in May of 2015. And so the president and the vice president are tenure. We have 2-year terms. So I'm in the second half of my tenure, and it's been fantastic.
And who is your vice president?
Adam Sachs, and he's he actually has he's been in the ABA longer than I have. I'm relatively new to the ABA myself, and he really keeps me grounded. So it works out. It's a really nice balance between the two of us.
So as president, you must have a business here in town. So what is your business?
So my business is called Acumentary. Up until recently, it was Shift, and I do business coaching and executive coaching. And I think that that was sort of why it was such a natural fit. As I was participating in the ABA, I was thinking, I'm so passionate about helping businesses grow. And I think many of us had the sense that the ABA could participate in a lot of our community conversations in a different way. And I thought, well, this is sort of how I can give back to the community and to the town. I grow business, so this is how my business aligns with what we're doing here. Mm-hmm. And what's great is we've actually attracted, I think we have 4 business coaches that are now part of the ABA. So that idea of really helping businesses grow and, you know, what can we all do to mentor one another, share information, I think it's just sort of in our DNA now.
Yeah.
You know, just looking at who we're attracting.
So you've been with the ABA for a couple of years.
Yep.
How long have you been in Ashland?
I moved into Ashland in 1994.
Okay, so between 1994 and then, what were you doing? Was it this your own business or other things?
So this is actually my first business that I've had on my own.
Okay.
So I have worked for a variety of other companies in a lot of different industries.
Uh-huh.
And prior to starting my own company, I worked for a software company.
Mm-hmm.
And that was one of those, you know, you read about the startups and the big success stories.
Yeah.
Didn't go that way.
Yeah, unfortunately, it doesn't always.
No, it doesn't. But, you know, it was a great learning opportunity. So the nice thing about being in a startup is you get really resourceful and you're always put into a situation where you really need to become the expert mm-hmm. of a subject matter. You don't have resources.
Right.
So the nice thing is you really get exposed to all aspects of business. And I was the chief operating officer, so I really had purview into a lot of operations.
Okay.
And a lot of... okay, I've got to figure out how to do this myself.
Yeah.
And I think that that's what's really led into partnering with business owners and executives to be, well, okay, we can figure this out, because I know we can. But we had one of those very long, it took us a long time to actually get where we wanted to go. We had a couple of, you know, setbacks with the economy.
It happens.
But it happens. It
oh,
really
yeah,
happens.
It does.
And it happens as to all the businesses.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes it's an opportunity to... you know, reinvent yourself or reinvent a product.
Right.
And I think that that's sort of what we're doing with the ABA right now. It was an opportunity for us to reinvent ourselves because there's so much change and such, you know, positive energy going on right now. Actually, at this point, we have so many great ideas coming in and out of the organization. It's hard to do some of them because of the energy and the change.
So that leads to my next question. So you said you're in the second half of your tenure as president.
Mm-hmm.
What goals do you have to finish, or like, what would you like to see happen in the next year for the ABA?
So that is a great question. So my primary objectives would be to continue to grow our membership base.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that with the new website coming on board, with a lot of the new programs that we've done, including partnering and doing social media internships
right.
with the high school, and places where we found where businesses can really partner with the community,
yeah.
I think that that will continue to grow if we keep on the trajectory. But we'd really like to have Ashland have a really strong business voice. And I think participating in the ABA lets people participate in that, because I think that businesses have an integral part in growing community. You know, I talk to people all the time who wish we had a this in town or wish we
right.
had a that in town. And there are ways for us to come together as a community and help to kind of scape out what we want for a business landscape. And I think there's just so much tremendous benefit that comes back to the community, whether it's part-time jobs for students or internships
right.
or just having the services that you want locally. There's certainly a tax basis, which we know.
Well, it's interesting. That's one of the big things that everyone says. We want more economic development. Right now, our split between business and regular residential tax is like 90-10. We'd love to build that to 15-85, so that we bring businesses in to help the economy, to help with those taxes, and take a little off the residential tax rate.
Well, I think, you know, especially given a lot of the votes that we just had, I mean, there's real need in the town
oh,
to
yeah.
take some of that burden yep. off of the individual
yeah.
taxpayer. And I think that the nice thing is that, you know, bringing in businesses and really supporting them and helping them grow and having the community involved is we can, I think it's great to have a voice in what types of business define
exactly.
your community.
Yes.
Right. So if you want to see a particular thing downtown, it's how do we partner with people? And there's a lot of really exciting partnerships that we've been
yes.
working with, and it's shifting the model. You know, I think in days past, there was sort of like an idea of sort of loyalty marketing,
mm-hmm.
like I'll donate to this and I'll donate to the PTO and that's
right.
how I'm going to keep my customer base. But the reality is most people have Amazon.com bookmarked on their screen.
Right. Right.
So there needs to be a different conversation. Mm-hmm. And, you know, how do we partner so that everybody's winning of it? Because,
right.
you know, not everybody wants to go pay $10 more for something.
Right. For a local business versus online.
Right. So there's got to be something else that's in the conversation. So
good.
I think it's a really exciting time for that. So I think that's a really one of our primary objectives, to continue to help our businesses grow mm-hmm. and get strong and get the programs that they need. We do a lot of programming, just helping businesses know how to market themselves, be heard, be seen in a way that works for them. Don't be somebody else, be yourself.
Right.
So I think that's a really big initiative. I think the membership base is big, working on the website and making sure that serves the community mm-hmm. the way we hope it will. And, you know, with any company, with any organization, the next big thing is making sure that the succession story works well. So mm-hmm. it will be about, okay, so this has been a great opportunity. And really unique opportunity to partner with the town differently.
Right.
So, you know, finding the next person to be the president who wants to continue some of this work will be a big part of this year, too.
Good, good.
Yeah.
Well, it's nice to see a woman leading this organization. You have some great ideas. So before you go, there's always one question I ask all my guests.
Okay.
When it's their first time on the show.
Okay, terrific. Actually, what I want to say one thing is,
sure.
So just so you know, the history of the ABA.
Go ahead.
The ABA has been around for a little while, and I am hardly the first female president.
Oh, I know. They've
so there's been
ones.
A nice
yes.
legacy of both
yes.
men and women. So I just want to make sure.
No, I know
I'm
that.
Not unique. Okay.
I do know that. Because we're, you know, the Ashland Business Association has been around for a very long time.
For a very long time.
I don't know exactly how long, but I know when I first ran for school committee back in 1996 or 7, maybe a little later, they were already in existence then,
yes.
and they had been in existence at that point for a long time. So,
right, right. It's,
yeah.
it's been chaired by some formidable women
yes.
in town.
Yes. Before I let you go, though,
okay.
So the question I have for all first-time guests on Around the Clock is there something about you, Alex Carlton, that not many people know that you'd be willing to share with our viewers?
Oh boy, something about me. Well, that's a great question. There's probably something about me that not a lot of people would guess.
Okay.
So I will share this.
Okay.
A lot of people who know me outside of the business organization or around town or on Facebook know that I participate in athletics a lot.
Mm-hmm.
So they'll see triathlon pictures and cycling pictures and all these sorts of things. And I know myself. When I see things in social media, I make up all kinds of great stories about the person, whether they be true or not.
Right.
So I think one of the things that people don't realize, and one of the things that's been sort of a blessing and a curse and sort of fueled my career and at moments hindered it, is one of the things that I struggle with is anxiety.
Okay.
So I have race anxiety. I have all these kinds of things that I've learned to manage over my lifetime. And I don't usually post those pictures, you know, of the, oh my gosh, what have I signed up for? But I think that it's always helped, you know, because it's sort of like when the anxiety can switch over to excitement, and I can have learned, you know, certainly a lot of strategies over my lifetime
right.
to manage it. And we all have it sometimes.
Of course.
I think it's made me very motivated to learn what I'm getting into and to just trust myself. And I think that it's really helped me step up to big challenges a lot. And my father used to always say, I'm like a duck. All the paddling's under the water. It looks calm and cool on the surface. But that would be something.
Well, good. Thank you for sharing that. Because I think for a lot of people, anxiety may sometimes stop them from doing things. So to know that it can be overcome and you can do some great things even when you have that anxiety, I think is encouraging for people. So thank you for sharing that.
You're very welcome. I also talk to a lot of people, younger people in high school and stuff, because I see a lot more of it now
yeah.
with younger people. So I think it's really important for everybody to just know that there's people all over the place with these things.
That's right.
Yep.
That's right. You never know the full story behind someone.
Exactly. Exactly.
Well, Alex, thank you so much for coming on Around the Clock. And it's been great having this conversation and hearing more about Ashland Business Association. And hopefully as you finish up your tenure, maybe we can have you back. And
I would love that. And I would love for anybody who has a small business in town. This is home-based businesses,
mm-hmm.
Sole proprietor, anything. Come out and check out a meeting. We've got people who will provide great support. If you're, you know, a lot of people running home-based businesses don't have that
right.
sense of community and people to kind of like shoot ideas around
yeah.
with, but we've got a great group, so come check us out as well.
Good. Well, thank you again.
Thank you.
Great. Well, that's it for this segment. Stay with us and we'll be back with more Around the Clock.
Welcome back to Around the Clock. It's time for our Around the Town tour. This is where we take you through different events that have happened in Ashland. Our first stop is the Community Center for the Rail Transit District Forum. This happened on June 9th, and we had probably about 70 people come out and talk to us about their concerns about the Rail Transit District. If you're not familiar where it is up off of the MBTA Road, also known as Magunko Hill. The developer has already started taking trees down and started construction. The town is reviewing its blasting plan for that area, looking at some studies in regards to water impact for around the Nyanza Cap and into the brooks and the runoff from there. So we thank everyone who came out and for participating, and it was great hearing their concerns. From the Rail Transit District Forum, we go to an event that everyone looks forward to here in Ashland, the Farmers Market Opening Day. The day started out nice and sunny. We got to talk to a lot of people. One of the things, as I asked people what their favorite thing was about the farmers market, other than the food, was the social aspect of the farmers market. You get to see people who you might not otherwise get to see in a relaxed atmosphere, maybe over breakfast or lunch at one of the great food vendors, but talking to people, finding out how people have been. But it's also a great opportunity to find out what's going on in town. You can stop at the town tent and see any of the committees that are there on a weekly basis, or the community tent and see any of the organizations there. And of course, there's always great music. And as I spoke to two people, both Michael Herbert and Steve Mitchell let us know that Yummy Mummy was their favorite food vendor, though they did enjoy all of them. So let's take a look at the farmers market. Good morning. Around the Clock is taking our Around the Town tour, and we are at opening day of the Ashland Farmers Market. It is a great Saturday morning, and the crowd is unbelievable.
We've stopped by the community tent, and we ran into Betsy Emberly. Betsy, hello.
Hi there. How are you?
I'm good. So, the community tent, can you tell us what the community tent is?
The community tent is the it's the space that is used revolving with different volunteer organizations and support organizations for throughout town. So this opening day, it's the Friends of the Library. Another day, it will be Decisions at Every Turn. Another day, it may be the PTO or the AFI or the Lions. I don't know what the schedule is, but that's every organization gets a turn.
Right, and it's different then. So the community tent is for the nonprofits and those kinds of organizations. And then we have the town tent, which we'll be stopping at, which is for boards and committees that are official boards and committees for Ashland, which I think is great that the farmers market supports these. So opening day, what are your thoughts?
I'm glad that it's not pouring, and it's so much fun to be here with the steady stream of people in Ashland, because it's still a small town where, you know, you recognize most of the faces, so getting to greet people and connect on a sunny day is nice.
And all the people that you haven't seen all winter, because we've all been inside, you get to see on at the farmers market.
Yes. And all the families and the dogs, people bring their dogs. There's one right on cue.
But that's what makes it so much fun.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, good. Well, thanks for speaking with us, and I'm sure we'll see you around on other farmer market days. Okay, thanks.
Thanks.
We are now in front of the town tent, and the town tent is different from the community tent in that this is where boards and committees that represent different groups and offices here in Ashland get to come and present their material and talk about the great things that they're working on. And today we have with us Megan, who is our new conservation agent, and Carl Hackinson and Jean Crouch. Thank you. Names sometimes go away. Carl and Jean are here representing the Conservation Commission. So, Megan, tell us a little bit about what you are showing and what you're talking to people about today.
Sure. So a lot of displays were actually brought in by residents and by Carl Hackinson, as well as other conservation commissioners who aren't right here right now. We oversee the Wetlands Protection Act here in town. We also oversee land management and land acquisition. So our display today is mainly about that information.
Okay. Carl and Jean, you guys have been here before, but I'm going to hand you the mic. Talk a little bit about, you know, what you're trying to show people today.
Well, I'm kind of serving a dual role here from the Conservation Commission and from the Land Stewardship Committee, which is a subcommittee of the Conservation Commission. And our role is really to take care of Warren Woods and any other land that's under care and custody of the Conservation Commission. And so some of the stuff here has to do with Warren Woods. We have trail maps. We have one of the kiosks from one of the fields. And so that's what I'm representing here. And matter of fact, I have to leave pretty soon to go up to Warren Woods and do some mowing up there.
I'm really here mostly just to answer questions that people might have, explain what the Conservation Commission is, what its role is, what its purpose is, and if people have any questions, we can certainly, you know, point them in the right direction in terms of any jurisdictional issues or regulations or anything that they might be interested in.
And Gene's been on the commission for 25 years? Or?
Yeah, maybe more. A while. So.
Okay. So what are some of the biggest questions that you're finding people are having today, Megan?
Mainly, we have a historical photo that's over there, and they're asking about WACA Field. That is a huge visual for them, I believe. They're also asking about a topographic map that one of the local artists brought in.
Okay. Now, Carl, you're also standing there with your beats. Mm-hmm. So you obviously did some shopping today.
Yeah, one of the downsides of being in the booth is you have to be in the booth. And I have to admit, I haven't been in the booth too much. Between talking to people and trying to take advantage of the market myself. So I do have a bundle of beets here for my wife. So
what, Megan, is this your first time coming to our farmers market?
It is.
Okay. So Jean and Carl, you guys have been here. What's your favorite thing about the market?
Just the community spirit, I think. You know, it's just everyone's here. Everyone is here and happy, but it's also a great vehicle for having a community conversation about what's going on in town.
Right. No, I agree. It's a great opportunity to connect with people that we don't normally see, answer questions and so forth, and I'm actually amazed how many people are here today. It's pretty inspiring.
To get people to recycle and especially compost more, so we have compost, recycling, landfill, and there's actually, like, we had to empty the compost once already, so that's, like, that's what's producing the most product right now, which is a really good thing. We have almost nothing in landfill. We haven't had to change that or recycling too much, so it's going really well.
What makes you want to come and work at the market?
Well, I mean, being in the area, I've seen this a lot, so I came, checked it out, and we also need community service for school, and they're offering that for us to be here, and it's a good way to give back to the community, I think, and my parents like to buy stuff from here, so.
There you go.
Yeah, I saw that some of my friends come here last year, so I decided to come and check it out, and it's a good place to see people from our community and town, and see, like, the stores here, too.
Good. Okay. Do you guys have to be at this post all day, or do you get to shift around?
We can shift around.
Shift around. Good. Good. Well, thanks for talking to us. Thanks for volunteering, because I know that the farmers market is all volunteer, and without volunteers like you guys, it wouldn't be the great success that it is. So thanks for helping out, and thanks for talking to me on Around the Clock. Okay.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. So we're talking to different people here at the market, and we've run into Valentina. Hi, Valentina. How are you?
Good.
How old are you?
Almost seven.
Almost seven. So what grade are you finishing?
First.
First grade. Who was your teacher this year?
Mrs. Temple.
Mrs. Temple. She's been there a while. She's a really good teacher. Did you like her?
Yeah, she's really nice.
Good. Well, we're next to the carve. Are you waiting for some food?
Yep.
What are you waiting for?
I don't know yet, but it's a good food.
It's good food. Yeah. Have you had their food before?
No.
No? So it's the first day of the farmer's market. Did you come to the farmer's market last year?
Yeah.
Yeah? What do you like about the farmer's market?
That it has great food.
Great food. Yeah. Do you get to see your friends too?
Yeah, lots of them in my class.
Nice, nice. We are now speaking with Steve Mitchell, who is on the board. What is your exact title for the farmers market, Steve?
Well, actually, I am technically the vice president of Ashland Healthy Harvest, which is the 501c3 that runs the farmers market.
Now, when did it turn into Ashland Healthy Harvest?
During our second year, we realized we needed to move forward in terms of a 501c3, and for a lot of reasons, obviously. So that was when we started that process, and it took us about a year to become a registered nonprofit.
So fifth opening day of the market. How's it feeling today?
It's tremendous. I mean, the weather's been cooperative, and that's been really such a big part of our success is the weather. But it's just great. I mean, for me, it's been very satisfying in terms of, just the community component of this. I think it's just a great event, and obviously the community's embraced it in a major way. Not just, the residents, but, town government has as well, as you know. So it's just been a real community involvement, so it's great.
So as we talk to people, we say, so who's your favorite vendor at the farmers market?
So we're standing in front of my favorite vendor here, but I will say, let me clarify that, because I they're all my favorites, but I do make a special effort when Yummy Mummy is here. They specialize in brownies, and I have to put a plug in for the salted caramel brownie. It is outrageous.
Okay. How many vendors show up on a Saturday morning?
So today, actually, we have 42 tents here. Now, that includes our artisan vendors as well. It includes our community service, our town government tent. Right. So right now, we're probably on average around 35 per week. This is opening day is a little bit bigger than normal. Yeah.
And you go until when?
We go until October, and I'm going to blow the date right now, but let's say it's October the 15th is basically our...
Like the second Saturday in October. Now, you've added some new theme days. What were the new added additions this year?
Well, probably the major one is we always had, in the past, we've had an Indian cultural day. We've expanded that into just a culture fest. So we're trying to extend... the diversity of Ashland. We have a Brazilian population, we have a Russian population, we've got a Thai population. So we're trying to bring a lot more of those ethnic diversities to the market. So
yeah, and we're able. Our cultural council will be here in the town tent on the Culture Fest day. So it was a nice mix of adding, as you said, not only vendors and community, but town government and committees that are doing things.
It's been great. I mean, we have our volunteer base, of course, is so critical to the success of the market. And, I think for me, I've gained an appreciation for the diversity of our students in town. So it should be fun. Should be a fun day.
Good. Well, Steve, thanks for helping us kick off and allowing us to talk to you. And I hope it's a great other market season. I'm sure we'll see you again through the summer.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you. We're here with Joanna Robbins. Joanna is an Ashland resident, and she was willing to talk to us about the market. Joanna, opening day, how are you feeling?
I love coming here. I've been able to socialize with an awful lot of people I know. It's great fun.
And connect with people that you didn't know. We just found out that we had children who graduated from the same class in Ashland High School.
That's true, and some of my son's friends that he graduated with are also here as well.
What's your favorite thing about the market?
Socializing. I do buy food. I picked up a bagel.
There you go.
But I do enjoy socializing.
Fate to make it show. I don't know if you think you're done. If you get a tip, well, tell it to the Eskimos. It's cold on shoulder. You know that you get a little colder.
As we continue around town, another event that was happening also on that Saturday, June 11th, was the Relay for Life. This is a fundraiser for cancer research. It's a 24-hour time where teams pledge money, they get people to pledge money, and they spend the 24 hours at the Ashland Middle School track. They pitch their campsites and their tents. They're there for 24 hours walking and raising funds, all in the name of cancer research. It was a rainy Saturday, but I think they did a great job raising some funds. So let's go visit the track. We're going to go from the middle school track to the Warren School, where we had a public forum on Route 126 project, also known as the Pond Street project. We let people know that we are still at our 25% engineering. We're looking to work with MassDOT to get an official 25% public hearing, which should be happening sometime at the end of the summer or maybe September. But the big thing was to let people know that we are working to keep our project in 2020 on what's known as the TIP, which is federal transportation dollars coming into Massachusetts. And as of right now, our understanding is that we are on 2020. The project will be going out for public comment, and we are hoping that people will reach out and support the project and help us stay in 2020. There was some great discussion at the forum and some great questions answered.
We are pushing, we are attending every MPO meeting because, again, I can't stress it enough, this is a sales job. We have other towns, Newton, Brookline, Everett, Cambridge, Chelsea, they all have infrastructure projects. And it's they get up, and they stand up, and they talk to the MPO members, and it's we're vying. We're vying. Tom Santacampo said that this is a sales job, and it absolutely is. We have to stay on top of this. It's not like we can just say, oh, you know what, we're on the 2020 tip, and then just let it go. We can't, because this is a process. It's a political process in Massachusetts, and I'm sure every state across the country. And this essentially is a full-time job for a lot of us in terms of how this process operates. So we're doing our best in terms of safety, and the light will be at a trip. It's on the plan. You can look at it over there. It's that green piece. The road will be realigned, and there will be a light coming out of that street.
Another stop on our Around the Town tour is the Main Street Fire Station for the Fire Memorial held on the second Sunday of June. It was attended by the majority of our Ashland firefighters, as well as Chief Davis and a number of members of our Ashland Police Department. It is a time to remember those who have lost their lives in their service as firefighters to Ashland. It started at the Main Street Fire Station, then the trucks rolled up to the Wildwood Cemetery, and there in front of the Firefighters Memorial, a few prayers and brief words were said. We then are able to show you the trucks coming back down to the Main Street Fire Station, where some camaraderie was held with some coffee and breakfast and just some nice conversation. It was a very reserved memorial service, but it was well respected, and we want to thank those who have lost their lives in service to Ashland as firefighters. Our last stop on the Around the Town tour is up at Magunko Hill, actually back near the middle school, where Dan Borelli is inputting an art installation, a permanent art installation, tied into his Nyanza art project. Google Nyanza and you will see all the information you need to know, but also Google Dan Borelli. He is an artist who works at Harvard University. He is a resident of Ashland, or was a resident of Ashland, knew people affected by the Nyanza project, the Nyanza die, and he has created a great tribute and an understanding for people as to what it was. It was one of the first Superfund sites, and I think for many people to understand is we are still being monitored by the EPA and DEP, but for most people in town, there is no health concern in regards to the Nyanza project. So check out Dan Borelli, and that's it for our Around the Town tour. I hope you've enjoyed seeing the different sights and sounds that are going on here in Ashland. We'll be bringing you footage of future farmer markets, as well as of our summer concert series that are starting next week, and the family theater nights, and anything else. If you have anything you'd like to share happening here in Ashland, make sure you reach out to Around the Clock, either on Facebook or through WACA, and we'd love to cover it.
Forget you, babe, but it's only
It's summer, and nothing says summer like baseball. The Ashland Legion Summer Baseball League is starting their games, and they're in full swing up at the Ashland High School baseball fields. So if you enjoy baseball, you can see some great baseball close to home for a lot less money than going into Boston. Support our local athletes. You can check out their schedule and go see some fun, great baseball right here in Ashland. Another upcoming event is the WACA-TV Film and Acting Workshop. It's held right here at the WACA Studios on Butterfield Drive. It is August 1st through the 5th from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. every day. And it is for those 13 to 15-year-olds who are interested in film and acting and working with a camera and behind a camera. If you'd like more information, you can go to the WACA site. Space is limited, so if you have any interest, go there soon and register. Well, thanks for being with us today on Around the Clock. I hope you've enjoyed the show. A very special thank you to Alex Carlton of the Ashland Business Association. I hope you enjoyed our Around the Town tour, and hopefully we'll see you at the farmers market. Some things to think about that are coming up to all of our students who are getting ready. I hope you have a great last day of school. And if the summer reading program is the grade that you're in, I hope you participate with the Friends of the Ashland Public Library. We also have our summer concert series on Tuesday nights at Stone Park. And of course, the ever-popular family movies also at Stone Park, but near the pavilion, and those are on Thursday nights. So enjoy the summer, stay safe, don't get sunburned, and we'll see you on the next show.
Hi there, folks. Chef Jamie here, and today I'm going to teach you how to make an amazing pizza. Step one.
Cut! Jamie, we're supposed to be teaching them how to make an amazing short film, not an amazing pizza.
Oh? You're so right. My bad. Hey guys, Director Jamie here, and today I'm going to teach you how to make a short film with us at the 2016 WACA-TV and Film Acting Workshop. Here's what you need to know. It runs from August 1st to August 5th from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. with a half hour for lunch. The campers must be 13 to 15 years old, and the program is $300 per camper. You also must bring a packed lunch. Let's get started. Step one, you can't make an amazing movie without an amazing screenplay. We'll help you write one.
Jamie, they already made a movie about the Titanic.
What movie?
Titanic.
Oh yeah. Step two. Hey you, get out of here, you nincompoop! It's me, Jamie. I'm just acting. We'll give you some acting lessons too, just in case if you want to be a star like me.
Sup?
Hey, Paul, do you want my autograph?
No.
Are you sure? Come on, I'm important.
No, thanks.
Come on, I got a pen right here.
I know.
Please, Paul,
I said no.
I'm right here.
I don't want it. Again.
Step three. Learn how to use a bunch of awesome film equipment, like cameras, microphones, and lights. We have everything you need to create your masterpiece. And the final touch is adding the pepperoni.
This has absolutely nothing to do with pepperoni.
Oh, you're right.
Ow! You got pepperoni in my eyes!
Sorry!
Once you film your movie, we'll take a few weeks to edit it, and then you can come by and pick up your complimentary DVD. Cinema.
There's only 12 spots open, so visit our website, fill out an application, send it to the address below, and let's get cooking. I mean filming.